What you're about to witness is one of the most sinister sounding intros to a trailer to one of the greatest epics ever produced. And there's more. Because you are going to see it as well.
Yes, it.
Yes, it.
There is a very harmful bacteria lurking in the water supplies that is actually an amoeba that is brain-eating.
Brain-eating amoeba. Listen, the unprecedented impact of the storms that we have had with all the floodwaters in quantities that we have never seen, what happened in Texas. This is going to lead to a lot of stagnant water. This is going to lead to a lot of contamination and a potential health hazard that's going to linger for years. You know, even today, since 2005, we're still seeing cases of contaminated water from Katrina. So you can only well imagine what this is going to create in the next 2 or 3 years. Look, the short term, we have health issues when it comes to stagnant water, which is, you know, the sewer, you know, all the bacteria that typically goes with contaminated water, E. coli, Salmonella. You're also going to have a lot of contaminated water because of chemicals. You know, this is water that's gone all over the place. There's a lot of, you know, physical plants that have a lot of chemicals and pesticides that contaminate waters. But what you're talking about is this brain-eating amoeba that's been popping up as of late. There's been 143 cases. You know, in the sense of a disease, it's not a lot, but 143 cases is turning out to be a lot. And the problem is that it's almost 99% fatal. Because you get it, you know, you get it from contaminated water. Typically, you get it through your nose. So, you know, if you're swimming in a contaminated lake, in a hot spring, or in any kind of pond that you think is safe, no, it's not, especially down in South where the waters are very, very warm. And once this amoeba, which is a parasite, gets through your nostrils, it goes right into your brain, and then it gives you a disease that you know, when they take you to the hospital, most doctors don't think of it. They think that you're having a meningitis or an encephalitis, and by the time they make the diagnosis, it's too late because, you know, again, antibiotics are not treatable.
Well, when you first heard of this, I mean, I was thinking drinking water. So you're saying it goes through your nose. So this is actually water that you're swimming in.
Water that you're swimming.
I don't want
the water that you might be bathing with. You know, one of the things that we tell people now as people are going back to areas of Florida, let's say your house has been empty for a long time and you have stagnant water in the pipes that have not been
or
running.
Or in your swimming pool.
In your swimming pool. But again, you know, once the systems, the chlorination begins to take place, then the amoeba issue then becomes more relevant to lakes and ponds and hot springs. But if you're going to an empty house, let's say that has not had running water for a long time, the stagnation of small water in the pipes, along with the heat, can lead to this amoeba being present. So that, you know, we tell people right now, run your water for at least 15 minutes before you start even thinking of utilizing that water.
I don't want to scare people too much. I want them to be aware of what to look for if, God forbid, you are contaminated. Are there symptoms? Because you talk about how the treatment of this is so dire that can you find symptoms early?
Well, the symptoms are typical. You know, you get the fever, you get the nauseousness, you get the confusion.
How soon after contamination, though, do you start to feel those symptoms? I mean,
Probably within a day
or
so, you know, probably within a day or so. If you have, you know, this ingestion of the amoeba, it goes up to your nose through the nerve fibers into your brain tissue. And then, you know, within 2 or 3 days, you start seeing inflammation of the covering of the brain and the brain itself. And then it brings all the typical, you know, visual disturbances, nauseousness, headaches, that kind of stuff. So it's, you know, right now, I think for a lot of healthcare systems down in the South, I mean, doctors, you know, are going to be thinking a lot about patients that come with these types of symptoms in regards, especially in areas that have been devastated by the water, because you have to think about all the potential contaminants, including this amoeba.
Maybe stay out of the water.
Absolutely.
For quite some time. All right. Dr. Manny Alvarez, thank you.
You got it.
In the United States, copyright law allows for the fair use of copyrighted material under certain limited circumstances without the prior permission from the owner. Under the law, determinations of fair use take into account the purpose of the use, the nature of the copyrighted work, the amount and substantiality of the work used in relation to the work as a whole, and the effect of the use upon the potential market for the copyrighted work. Other jurisdictions may have similar copyright provisions protecting fair use or fair dealing. If you are uncertain as to whether a specific use qualifies as a fair use, you should consult a qualified copyright attorney.
You have the right to take it down.